So good afternoon, everybody. My name is Sandy Flaherty, and I'm the Director of Admission and Catholic Identity here at Mercy High School. And I've worked here a long time, so I worked with Sandy and members of our advancement team who work very closely with Sandy are all here in full support and to show their love and affection for Sean, for Kelsey and Daniela, and all of the members of the Albers family and extended family through friendship. So I want to welcome you. For Sandy, this was a home away from home, so I want to extend that to you as well. Please feel as comfortable as possible, and we can be a little informal, even though the surrounding is quite formal, but we can be informal. We're all friends. Our relationship and love for Sandy brings us together today, so that is a beautiful friendship and communion that we share. In planning the memorial service today, one of the things that really touched my heart about Sandy, and I feel like my relationship with Sandy grew much stronger when her daughter Tracy died. And I went to the family home and I had dinner with Sean and Mom and Sandy. And it was at that point that I began to see the deep love that Sandy had for her kids. It was palpable, it was beautiful. And so when I was thinking about the prayer service, I really thought about the beauty of motherhood and what motherhood means. And I know some of the young women here are pregnant, but that the welcoming of a beautiful baby and the first time you look into the eyes of that baby and as they become toddlers and then the first time they go to school and the first time they come home crying and then the first date. And so the beauty of it, but also the reality of it is I know in a mother's heart that can be filled with some struggle because you want to give the very best to your children. So I found a beautiful poem that I wanted to read you, and it's called A Mother's Love. So that's kind of our introduction to our prayer this afternoon. A mother's love is something that no one can explain. It is made of deep devotion and of sacrifice and of pain. It is endless and unselfish and enduring come what may, for nothing can destroy it or take that love away. It is patient and forgiving when all others are forsaking, and it never fails or falters, even though the heart is breaking. It believes beyond believing when the world around condemns, and it glows with all the beauty of the rarest, brightest gems. It is far beyond defining. It defies all explanation. And it still remains a secret like the mysteries of creation. A many-splendored miracle we cannot understand, and another wondrous evidence of God's tender guiding hand. So one of the readings that we picked is from the Hebrew Scriptures, or more commonly referred to as the Old Testament, but it is from Proverbs, and it's a beautiful reading about women and the prize they are in their families. And so Carol, who is from our advancement team, is going to share that with you.
One finds a worthy woman, her value is far beyond pearls. She is a trusting and unfailing prize. She brings good and not evil all the days of her life. She rises while it is still night and distributes food to those in need. She is strong and sturdy woman, She enjoys her successes, and at night her lamp is undimmed. She opens her hands out to the poor and extends her arms to the needy. She fears not the cold. Her family is always doubly clothed. Strength and dignity are her clothing, and she laughs at the days to come. She opens her mouth in wisdom, and the teaching of kindness is on her tongue. Her children rise up and praise her. Many are the women of proven worth, but you have excelled them all. Charm is deceptively beauty, and beauty is vain. The woman who loves the Lord is to be praised. Give her the reward of her labors, and let her works praise her at heaven's gates. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
The second reading we chose this morning is a reading actually from Genesis. So Sandy, Clarity and I were talking about Sandy, and one of the things I said that I always admired about Sandy when she worked here, she was always very warm. And when we talk about mercy, we talk about one of our characteristics is a very place of hospitality. And I felt like whether you're walking into the advancement offices or walking into her home, whatever was going on, she always stopped and really paid attention to the people that were there offering hospitality. And it wasn't a sugar-coated hospitality. It was also knowing that suffering was really a part of life, with her own physical ailments throughout her life, and also, as Sandy mentioned, when her daughter died and her husband. She met suffering actually with grace and kindness and was very real. This reading that I'm going to read in a moment is really about paying attention to what's happening, because you never know when angels are around us. And I think Sandy was one of those angels for us. A reading from the book of Genesis. The Lord appeared to Abraham near the great trees of Mamre while he was sitting at the entrance to his tent in the heat of the day. Abraham looked up and saw three men standing nearby. When he saw them, he hurried from the entrance of his tent to meet them and bowed to the ground. He said, "If I have found favor in your eyes, my Lord, do not pass your servant by. Let a little water be brought, and then you may all wash your feet and rest under this tree. Let me get you something to eat, so you can be refreshed and then go on your way, now that you have come to your servant." "Very well," they answered. "Do as you say." So Abraham hurried into the tent to Sarah. "Quick," he said, "get 3 sleeves of the finest flour and knead it and bake some bread." Then he ran to the herd and selected a choice tender calf and gave it to the servant, who hurried to prepare it. He then brought some curds and milk and the calf that had been prepared and set these before them. While they ate, he stood near them under a tree. "Where is your wife, Sarah?" they asked him. "There in the tent," he said. Then one of them said, "I will surely return to you about this time next year, and Sarah, your wife, will have a son." The word of the Lord. So, in a moment, Beverly, who is in our advancement department, is going to sing a song called Hail Mary, Tense Woman. And the song is about, in the Catholic tradition, we honor Mary, the mother of Jesus. And we see her as the great model of what motherhood is all about, in that she received Jesus as a child. In the Jewish tradition, she would be the one to teach him his prayers when he was a little boy and care for him. And then when he made his way to the cross, she was with him to the end. So the great love and devotion of a mother for her children. So what we asked is,
Kelsey and other members of the family, if during the song, if you want to come up and place one of these beautiful red roses into the vase, we would love to have you do that. Mercy, as we gather as a community of faith, we pray in a special way for the Albers family during this time of their loss. We pray that your healing touch will bring comfort and solace to Daniel, to Kelsey, Danielle, and Sean during this time of separation. God of mercy, we also pray in thanksgiving that Sandy has been reunited with her husband Ron and her daughter Tracy. May Sandy's homecoming in heaven be filled with gentleness and abundant love. For this we pray to the Lord.
We are mindful that as a community, you have watched over and guided us from the day that Catherine McCauley opened the first House of Mercy in Dublin, Ireland. As we mourn the loss of our friend Sandy, we remember her kindness, gentle presence, honesty, sense of humor, and dedication to mercy. We ask for your tender graces, especially for the members of our advancement department who worked side by side with her for many years. May we recognize that Sandy's presence remains with us as we work to keep Catherine and Holly's vision alive and thriving. For this, we pray to the Lord. Gracious God, during this session of thanks, may we be mindful of the support and love which family presides. May we move gently into thanksgiving and appreciate what is important, our loved ones. May our tables be filled with gracious hospitality, gentleness with one another, and a spirit of thankfulness for all the gifts that you have given us. For this we pray to the Lord. Lord Jesus, you are the resurrection and life. As we come to terms with the loss of our mother, grandmother, and friend, may we be mindful that you are the source of all healing and peace. Come be with us now as we join together in grief, thanksgiving, and hope. For this we pray to the Lord.
So it's an honor to speak to you today. I've known Sandy for 33 years, and Sandy and I met when I worked at Catholic Charities, and I hired Sandy to be an assistant in my office. And at that time, I was pregnant with my daughter. It was the beginning of 1990. And Tracy was pregnant with Kelsey. And about 3 months into our working together, we all went home for the weekend. And my husband and my daughter, who was two, Teresa, had the chicken pox. And I thought, oh, I'm having some contractions. And so I had a friend take me to the hospital. And lo and behold, I was in full active labor. And I said, oh no, that can't be, because my husband and daughter have chicken pox. And I was 31 weeks pregnant. And I said, well, you're staying here. And so I was hospitalized. Lo and behold, so was Sandy hospitalized that weekend with stage 4 ovarian cancer. So at that time, Sean was in high school. Stage 4 ovarian cancer in 1990. Was very hard to cure. And so I'm working from home with a computer that sits, you know, like about 10 feet away with a 25-foot cord to my bed to a keyboard because we didn't have laptops or anything then. And I called in to work, and so Sandy, I called a checkup on her, and I said, you know, how are you doing and how can I help? And she said, well, can I still have my job? And I said, you can absolutely have your job. What do you want? She goes, well, I'd like to try to work on the weeks I'm not sick. And I said, you can do whatever is going to give you the strength and hope to get through this. And she did. So she worked all through her treatment. So she would be really, really sick. Because you can imagine what chemo was like in 1990. And then, lo and behold, she would be back in, and I said, work whatever number of hours you want. And she did, and it got her through, and she survived stage 4 cancer. And that was really, truly a miracle. And a few years later, in 1993, I came to Mercy, and Sandy and I stayed in touch. And a few years later, meeting is someone to work part-time in our advancement office. So I said, well, I know someone. So I called Sandy, and that began the journey of 19 years when she worked for us. And it was just great joy when I was with her at Catholic Charities. Her mom was still alive and would come out and spend the winters with us. And she was an amazing baker. And her eyes is nodding, and she continued. Sandy learned to make all those wonderful baked goods, and she would make us all plates of cookies at Christmas time, which we all looked forward to because it had everything on it. I mean, anything you can imagine, it was on it. And I couldn't have made, you know, a fifth of those things. I would make like chocolate chip cookies, right? And Sandy had everything on it, and everyone looked forward to that. But she brought, you know, so much joy. And then she got cancer again while she was here at Mercy when she got breast cancer. And once again, she said, I want to work through it. And I said, whatever you want to do, we will support you. And she came to school with her head bald and her cow because it was what gave her strength and hope to be around the community, to be part of something. And then one year, a few years later, Sandy was a hairdresser by trade growing up after she got out of high school. We had our Dig Pink rally where the girls will donate their hair. And they asked Sandy if she would cut the hair at that rally. And that was such a meaningful moment to her to be part of that experience with our students as a breast cancer survivor, to be the one to help cut that hair that they were donating. And just quietly, humbly, beautifully, she shared that gift of herself with those girls and with all of us. And she just shares that gift and her love with each of you. And to her family, she just loved you from the depth of her soul. The pictures she shared always of each of you, the joy she had in celebrating the call. And you know, when I got promoted, looked at her picture, it's just like, all I could think of was my friend. And Sandy was a great friend to everyone in this room. And I can't thank all of you enough for letting Mercy be the place where we celebrate her life today. Because being part of this community was important to her as much as all of the different ways that each of you have known her. And she retired at 19 years, and the one thing she wanted was to make it to 20 years. But it was time for her to be home with Ron and to take care of him. But she was a gift to each of us, and I feel just so blessed. And I know she's in heaven, and I know she's in all of our hearts, and she will walk with each of you all the days of your lives, and she'll be looking down on you, and she'll be holding you in her hearts. And so, thank you for letting me share just my experience of Sandy and my love of her over these last 33 years.